Yeah, boy, look at that. It's all kinds of scraped up. Not really, but it's... You gotta start somewhere.
Squid!
Hey guys, so recently I saw a video from Downshift 83 talking about all the gear that he uses and all the gear that he has. I actually hadn't noticed that video until I saw Vilma here's jealous of Downshift 83's video, which was pretty freaking funny. I also had thought about doing something like this, like a product review for Girl Clutch, but I don't want to be the one making all the videos for Girl Clutch, so I'm kind of like holding off on a lot of the video ideas that I want to do for Girl Clutch because I want more girls involved in it. I don't want it to be all about me. That's what this channel's for. So anyway, let's get started with all the gear that I use. So the first thing is my Shoei RF1000 helmet, the Flutter. I'm not that girly, and I'm not too into the whole pink thing that goes on, but I still like being feminine. I saw this helmet a couple years ago, and now I had to have it. But it's real comfortable. It was kind of a pain in the butt to break in, especially because I used to use a chatterbox. I don't have one anymore. Don't ask me why the clip's still on there. I haven't taken it off. Don't judge me. It's really comfortable. It comes with, you know, the breath guard up here, and then it also comes with like a wind blocker thing down here. I actually like to use a boom mic. This thing right here. This mic, you know, it's movable, you can move it wherever you want to, so you could have it right up on your mouth, and it's a lot easier to be understood. My jacket is an Alpine Star Stella Ice, and I've had this for 3-4 years, something like that, when I started riding on the back of my ex-boyfriend's bike. Maybe that's another story for another vlog. I love it. It's broken in. It's dirty as hell. But, you know, it's real comfortable. I wish I could show you road rash on my jacket, but I can't. It just looks really dirty. But I swear it's road rash. You guys can barely see it. Again, a story for another vlog. I have the GP Plus gloves for women, and they're just regular gauntlet gloves, the carbon fiber knuckles, and the pinky and the ring finger are webbed together. Another thing that I noticed too is the seams like are on the outside instead of being sewn on the inside, so it doesn't irritate your fingers. Don't get like, they don't hurt after riding for a while. These are really comfortable. I can go long distances with these. My boots are City Lays, and you can tighten the calf up to fit you know, whether you're wearing jeans or in a suit. These did take a little while to get used to as far as shifting goes. Misshifted a whole bunch of times the first couple times I tried riding with these boots on. It's a different feeling because your, you know, ankle movement is really restricted. And my suit, my one-piece suit, my Stella Julie. A-star Julie? It's the Julie. I actually had initially wanted to get the Dainese Lady U suit because it looked more like a cat suit and I thought it was cooler, but I had tried on a couple different sizes when I was trying to figure out what size my suit I needed to get, and the Dainese just weren't as comfortable as the A-star was, and I lost a little bit of weight since I got the suit, so it feels a little big. I feel like a heifer in it, but like $800, so I don't want to buy another one. The suit also takes a little bit of getting used to when going from street clothes to riding in your suit, at least the first few times I was riding in it, because there's a whole lot of padding in the knee area, obviously, so when you're gripping onto your tank when you're riding, it's definitely a different feel from when your jeans. Also, an extra piece of equipment that I have is this back protector. My jacket and my suit, actually. My jacket and my suit actually have a little pocket in the back area that I can put this back protector in. So I used to interchange them, you know, when I went riding, but sometimes I'd forget when I put on my suit and I take off to Palomar or canyon carving somewhere, and I would rather honestly have this in my suit than in my jacket that I wear for everyday riding. The suit only goes on when I'm getting a little bit aggressive on the bike, so this stays in the suit for most times. But yeah, so that's my gear. That's all the gear I have. Very basic. but it suits all my needs. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you're a female and watching this and have any questions about gear or recommendations or anything like that, feel free to ask, and I will talk to you guys later. One more thing, I want to do in one of my next videos, I think it'd be fun to have another Q&A session. If you didn't see the old one, check it out. There were some legitimate questions, and then there were some, there were a couple weird ones. Most of you aren't on my Facebook because I'm not ready to go there in our relationship. Feel free to leave a comment, send me a message, email, whatever, and ask as many questions as you want, and if I don't get to all of them, I'll get the most interesting or the most frequently asked and whatnot.